Now we will discuss the boundedness of subsets of capital R. Capital R is set of real numbers. A non-empty subset of capital R, a set of real numbers, is called an aggregate. Boundedness of subsets of R. Under this heading, we are going to learn bounded above set, bounded below set, and bounded set. For this, let us consider an example. Let us take the example of NMC section. We know that NMC section consists of 60 students, starting from number 1 to 16. How do we represent this? Suppose if we say X belongs to NMC, then what about X? What are the values of X? What does X represent? Now, X represent NMC 1 or NMC 2 or NMC 3 or NMC 59 or NMC 60 or any number from 1 to 16. That's the meaning of X belongs to NMC. How do you express this using mathematical expression? See, without wasting our time writing 1, 2, 3 up to so on 60, we can use mathematical expression. What expression we are going to use here? We are going to use inequalities. How do you express this? We can write X is less than or equal to 60. What is X? Where X belongs to NMC. So here, this NMC 1 to 60 could be simply, you can write X is less than or equal to 60 for all X belong to NMC. Or we can also write X is greater than or equals to 1 for all X belong to NMC. When you say for all X belong to NMC, the maximum value is 60. What's the minimum value? 1. Or we can write, combining the above two inequalities, we can write simply as 1 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 60 for all X belong to NMC. Again, consider NMC section 1 to 60. As we have discussed in the previous slide, we can write X is less than or equal to 60 for all X belong to NMC. Now we say NMC is bounded above by 60. See, 60 is the highest number in NMC. So it is bounded above by 60, and the set NMC is called a bounded above set. Similarly, we can write X is greater than or equal to 1 for all X belong to NMC. And hence, using this inequality or this expression, we can say that NMC is bounded below by 1. And the set NMC is called a bounded below set. Combining these two, we can write 1 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 60 for all X belong to NMC. That is, NMC is bounded below by 1 and bounded above by 60, and hence we say that NMC is a bounded set. What is a bounded set? A set which is both bounded above and bounded below. Since the NMC is bounded above by 60, bounded below by 1, it is a bounded set. Now consider X is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 60. Now what we have done here? We have simply replaced NMC by S, because normally in the mathematics classroom, we use alphabetic letters. A, B, C, R, S, T, something. Now let us take capital S stands for 1 to 60. We can write X is less than or equal to 60 for all X belong to S. That is, S is bounded above by 60, and the set S is called a bounded above set. Similarly, X is greater than or equals to 1 for all X belong to S. Now we say that S is bounded below by 1 and the set S is called a bounded below set. Combining the above two inequalities, we can write one more inequality. 1 less than or equal to x, less than or equal to 16 for all x belong to S. And again, we say that S is bounded above by 16 and bounded below by 1. Hence, it is a bounded set. Now consider here, S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the third example I can say. In the first example, we have taken NMC. In the second example, we have taken S. There we have replaced NMC by S. In both cases, we have a finite number from 1 to 16. Whereas this S has infinitely many numbers, infinitely many elements. Starting from 1, what is the highest value, greatest value? We cannot say. Whereas in the previous two examples, the least number is 1 and the greatest number is 16. But here we can say only the least number. The least number is 1. What is the greatest number here? We don't know. Nobody knows. Now, let us consider this infinite set. How do you write this? Can you write x is less than or equal to any real number here? Is it possible to write? It is not possible at all. Because we don't know what is the greatest number in S. And hence we say that S is not bounded above. And the set S is not a bounded above set. Similarly, let us consider x is greater than or equal to 1. For all x belong to S. It is possible here. It is possible here. Whereas in the previous case, namely x is less than or equal to what number? We cannot give. But here we can give the number 1. And hence we say that S is bounded below by 1. And the set S is called a bounded below set. Therefore, this is an example of a bounded below set but not bounded above set. Since it is not bounded above, it is not a bounded set. Consider another example, capital A, which consists of the elements minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. It's a set. We need not write in the order. It goes on. What is the least number here? We don't know. What's the greatest number? Minus 1 is the greatest number. Therefore, we can write x is less than or equals to minus 1 for all x belong to A. Therefore, we say that A is bounded above by minus 1 and the set A is bounded above set. What about this case? Can he give any real number such that x is greater than or equal to that real number? No, it is not possible. It is not possible. Therefore, A is not bounded below. And the set A is not a bounded below set. And hence, this is an example of bounded above set, but not bounded below set. And hence, it is not a bounded set. Thus, we discussed four examples. NMC section 1 to 16, set S 1 to 16, both are bounded sets. Whereas another case is S is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. Other case is capital A equals to minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. Both are not bounded. Now, we define what is a bounded above set. A set S is said to be bounded above if there exists a real number k such that x is less than or equals to k for all x belong to the set S. The number k is called an upper bound for the set S. Any number greater than an upper bound is also an upper bound for the set. That's why we use an upper bound, because for a set, we have many more upper bounds. Sometimes we can have infinitely many upper bounds. Suppose U is an upper bound of S, and any real number which is less than U is not an upper bound of S, then U is called the least upper bound, or we say LUB, or we say supremum of S. What is supremum? Supremum is nothing but the least upper bound. The smallest upper bound is called the supremum. We write the supremum because whenever supremum exists for a set, that is unique. Therefore, we use the supremum. If U belongs to R, is the supremum of S, then for each epsilon greater than 0, epsilon is very small value, very, very small value, but greater than 0. Then U minus E is not an upper bound of the set S. Now we discuss bounded below set. In the same way, we can define bounded below. The only difference is, in bounded above, we write X is less than or equal to some real number. In bounded below set, we write X is greater than or equal to some real number. The only change is the inequality. A set S is said to be bounded below if there exists a real number L such that X is greater than or equals to L for all X belong to S. The number L is called a lower bound for the set. Here also we use A because for a set we can have finite number, one or more number of lower bounds. The note is any number less than a lower bound is also a lower bound for the set. For example, in NMC section, one is a lower bound. What about minus one? It's also a lower bound. Minus two, lower bound. But remember that minus one, minus two do not belong to the set. Therefore, the lower bound need not belong to the set. If V is a lower bound of S, then any real number greater than V is not a lower bound of S. For example, NMC section 1. 1 is a lower bound. What about 2? 2 is not a lower bound. 3 is not a lower bound. Any number greater than 1 is not a lower bound. Then 1 is called infimum there. Therefore, similarly here, if V is a lower bound of S and any real number greater than V is not a lower bound, then V is called the greatest lower bound, or LUB, or we call it as infimum of S. The greatest lower bound is called the infimum. So whenever infimum or supremum exists for a set, it must be unique. Therefore, for infimum and supremum, we use the article B. If B belongs to R, is the infimum of S, then for each epsilon greater than 0, B plus E is not a lower bound of S. What is a bounded set? We already discussed, a set is said to be bounded if it is both bounded above as well as bounded below. That is to say that we must have two real numbers. Here let us take L, K. Both are real numbers such that L less than or equal to X less than or equal to K for all X belong to S. And also we know that modulus of X is less than or equal to K. Then by inequality, we have minus K less than or equal to X less than or equal to K. Therefore, using this concept, the above inequality can be written using only one number. or the above definition can be rewritten as or equivalently. There exists a real positive real number k. It must be positive. Here l and k are simply real numbers, whereas here there exists a positive real number k such that modulus of x is less than or equal to k for all x belong to S. So this way also we can define bounded set. Example, any finite set is bounded, as we discussed in NMC section, which has elements from 1 to 60, which is finite. It has 60 elements. Therefore, NMC section is bounded. So any finite set is bounded. The set capital N, set of natural number, capital Z, set of integers, Q, set of rational numbers, capital R, set of real numbers of R, are not bounded, because it may fail. Sometimes it fails. A lower bound fails. Sometimes upper bound fails. Sometimes bounded above set fails. Bounded below set fails. In the case of N, it is bounded below but not bounded above. So, at least one of them fails here. Set of natural numbers, integers, rationals, real numbers are not bounded. The aggregate. Aggregate is nothing but subset of capital R. 1 plus minus 1 by N, such that N belongs to N, is bounded. We have some more examples. R minus is bounded above and 0 is an upper bound. R plus is bounded below and 0 is a lower bound. Capital N is bounded below but not bounded above. The set S is equal to 1 by N such that N belongs to N, which is both bounded above and bounded below. Here 0 is the infimum, sorry. 0 is the infimum, 1 is the supremum of the set S is equal to 1 by N such that N belongs to N. Now we will extend the same concept to the sequences. Now we are going to discuss the definition of bounded above sequence, bounded below sequence and bounded sequence. What is a bounded above sequence? A sequence AN is said to be bounded above if there exists K belongs to R such that AN, A suffix N is the nth term of the sequence, is less than or equal to K for all N belong to capital N. It must be true for each and every term of the sequence AN. As far as set concerned, we use some X, arbitrary element of S. But here, in the case of sequence, we take nth term of the sequence. That's the only difference between bounded above set and bounded below set. In the case of set, we choose one arbitrary element X from the set. Whereas in a sequence, we choose the nth term of the sequence. The rest are all same. Here the number k is called an upper bound for the sequence AN. Any number greater than an upper bound is also an upper bound for the sequence. If no such k exists, satisfying AN less than or equal to k for all N belong to N, then the sequence is not bounded above sequence. Example, consider the sequence AN. Is a well-known example, minus 1 to the power n. The sequence, minus 1 to the power n. Whose elements are? Minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1. It goes infinitely many times. The minus 1 and 1 repeat infinitely many terms. Here clearly, every term of the sequence is less than or equal to 1, because the highest value is 1. So we write an less than or equal to 1 for all n belong to n, because every term, when you say for all n belong to n, every term in the sequence is less than or equals to 1. Therefore, 1 is an upper bound for the sequence an. For example, 1.01, which is more than 1. 1, the number 1. 1.001, 1.1, 1.11, 2, 3, 3.001 are all upper bounds for the sequence an. But they need not belong to the sequence. Another example, an. The sequence an is 1 by n. Whose elements are 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4. Here also we can write an is less than or equals to 1 for all n belong to n. Here 1 is an upper bound for the sequence an, or any number greater than 1 is also an upper bound for the sequence. Consider another example, an equals to 1 by n. The sequence 1 by n, whose terms are 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, so on. Here also we can write an strictly less than 1. Whereas in the previous example, we can write an is less than or equal to 1 because 1 is included here. Whereas in this example, 1 is not there. Therefore, we can write, even then 1 is not there, we can express this as an less than 1 for all n belong to n. Or we can write an is less than or equal to 1 by 2 for all n belong to n. Therefore, 1, 1 by 2 are all upper bounds for the sequence. What about the sequence an is n, which has elements 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. This is nothing but a set of natural numbers. This sequence, here we cannot produce a real number k, such that an is less than or equal to k for all n belong to n. Hence, the above sequence is not bounded above sequence. Consider another example, an. The sequence an is n into minus 1 power n, which consists of elements minus 1, 2, minus 3, 4, minus 5, 6, minus 7, 8, so on. The sequence is also not bounded above. Whereas the sequence an is the sequence minus n, which is having elements minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on, is bounded above. And the 0 is an upper bound. Now, can we consider what is bounded below sequence? It is same as bounded below set. As I told you, just in the place of x, in the case of set, here we take an. That's all. A sequence an is said to be bounded below if there exists a real number L such that L is less than or equal to an, or you can write an is greater than or equals to L for all n belong to n. The number L is called here lower bound for the sequence an. Any number less than here lower bound is also a lower bound for the sequence. If no such number L exists, then it is not a bounded below sequence. Example, sequence an is minus 1 power n. It's a well-known example, very often we discuss, which consists of elements minus 1, 2, minus, sorry, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, so on. Here, clearly minus 1 is less than or equal to an, because every term in the sequence is more than minus 1 or equal to minus 1. Therefore, it is a lower bound for sequence an. So, minus 1 is a lower bound, and this sequence is a bounded below sequence. any number less than minus 1, namely minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, are all lower bounds of the sequence, but they need not belong to the sequence. The sequence AN equal to N squared, which consists of elements 1, 4, 9, 16, so on, is bounded below, and 1 is a lower bound. Now, what's a bounded sequence? A sequence AN is said to be bounded if it is both bounded above and bounded below. That is, if the range of the sequence is bounded. Like a bounded set, we will have two real numbers here, L, K, such that L is less than or equal to AN, less than or equal to K, for all N belong to N. Or equivalently, we say that there exists a real number. That real number must be a positive. That is, there exists a positive real number K, such that modulus of AN is less than or equal to K for all N belong to N. The above definition is, or in the above definition, we use two real numbers. Whereas in this definition, we use only one real number, which must be positive. Examples. The sequence minus 1 power N, that is equals to minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1 is bounded. Because 1 and minus 1 are its upper and lower bounds respectively. The sequence 1 by N, which consists of elements 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, so on, is also bounded. 1 is the least upper bound and 0 is the greatest lower bound. And see that here 1 belongs to the sequence, but 0 does not belong to the sequence. The sequence, namely N cube, another sequence minus 1 power n, n square, another sequence minus 2 power n, they are unbounded sequences. This is also some graphical representation of bounded above, bounded below sequences. If sequence A is bounded from above and below, it is called bounded. If a sequence is not bounded, in place we say that AN is unbounded. Now let us consider some more examples. XN stands for nth term of the sequence N. Here we can write XN is greater than N for all N. Therefore, in this example, the nth term is 9 minus N. This can be written as xn is less than 9 for all n. The other example is xn, whose nth term is sin n by n, or you can write sin x by x. Here, modulus of xn is less than 1. We know that for sin, the highest value is 1, the least value is minus 1. What about the first example, the sequence n, which is bounded below by 0? What about this example? Bounded above by 9. What about this example? Is both bounded above and bounded below. That is, it is bounded. Next, we will discuss the behavior of a sequence. A sequence may converge, may diverge, or oscillate. There are three behaviors of a sequence that we will discuss in the next